Back when Chinese immigrants first came to America, they wanted to recreate one of their favorite dishes, which is Chinese broccoli and beef. Unfortunately, Chinese broccoli was harder to find in the United States at the time, so they replaced it with broccoli, which was popularized by Italian Americans. And now, the beef and broccoli dish can be found in pretty much all Chinese American restaurants. It's become a staple, and it's also found its way onto sneakers. And this time, it's found its way onto my favorite Air Max, the Air Max 1. Air Max 1, beef and broccoli. This shoe is dropping on, I don't actually know what date in the United States. Still unknown, still hasn't confirmed the release date. It's going to come out for $140. This not being a premium, or at least I don't think it's a premium Air Max 1. They usually go for $150. This is just going to be $140. I hope it stays that way. Now, the beef and broccoli theme has been done on sneakers before, not just from Nike. New Balance has a bunch of them, like the 1960s, the 580s. Armelian Dior had a 993 beef and broccoli. Nike had the Air Force 1 beef and broccolis. So it's been done before, but this time, it's on my favorite Air Max, the Air Max 1. And first impressions of the shoe, it's a very, very rugged looking shoe. So if you're into that kind of outdoorsy, more tough look, this one is definitely for you. And overall, as I get older, I do like brown shoes more and more. I will say, I get the theme like beef and broccoli, but I will say the vintage green for me, it's just a type of green that I find it harder to wear. It's kind of close to the shirt that I'm wearing, but the brown and green combo, I just don't know if me personally, I can wear it that well. I'm not like a super trendy or fashionable guy. Pretty simple when it comes to how I would dress. But overall, in terms of the colorway, I do appreciate the beef and broccoli theme. The vintage green on sneakers with this brown, slightly out of my comfort zone. And the upper sole, there's a few different materials. The base layer, it's just mesh. Pretty standard for an Air Max 1. The mesh extends up to the tongue as well. And it's in this green color. Officially, it is vintage green. The swoosh is vintage green as well. But that comes in leather with like almost like a matte nubuck finish. So slightly different there. And you can see like this texture. Hopefully you can see it through the camera. There's like a little pattern there. And then on the overlays, it is hairy suede in the cacao brown color. Now, I'm not a huge fan of hairy suede, but I know some people do like that. And it does actually feel pretty nice, but just aesthetically, I don't love hairy suede. I much prefer like a smooth, very velvet and plush feeling suede. But if you're into this look, totally get it. And then on the darker brown parts of the shoe, so like at the bottom of the ice days, as well as the heel counter, that is also that kind of leather material with like a matte finish to it. And again, it has the same type of like texture and pattern to it. And at the top of the tongue, you'll see that Nike Air Max branding. What's slightly different when it comes to branding for this shoe is on the booty of the shoe, it goes to a swoosh, just a swoosh, no Nike branding on it, just a swoosh and then Air underneath. And that is embroidered onto the booty of the shoe. And the Air Max 1s comes with a foam midsole with a visible Nike Air unit on the heel, of course. And this is not a big bubble Air Max 1, just a general, I don't even know what you call it, but like the standard Air Max 1. So a smaller bubble. And just for comparison's sake, hope you can see the difference in size of the bubbles, as well as the difference in the midsole. And of course, a very iconic rubber waffle outsole. That is pretty standard as well for an Air Max 1. This one comes with like these white speckles on it. At first I thought it was dust and I was trying to like scrape some of it off, but yeah, that's how the shoe comes. The shoe doesn't come with any extra laces, and the laces that come out of the box, it's almost like black, very, very dark gray with speckles of brown and green all over. Kind of unique, kind of different. I don't know what other kind of color laces I would go with. Maybe white just to make it like super different and pop really loud, but out of the box, just these very dark gray laces. And the insole of the shoe, it is the same vintage green with brown Nike Air branding. Box of the shoe, about as standard of a Nike box as you can get. And in terms of size and comfort, I'm a wide footer. For Air Max 1s, I usually like to go up half a size. It's a pretty narrow and slender silhouette with a ton of padding inside. When I've gone true to size, I really do feel like width-wise, it's really hugging my feet too tight. So I prefer to go up half a size for my wide feet. Length-wise, that leaves a bit of wiggle room, but yeah, when I go true to size, it's just been too tight. And in terms of overall comfort, I think the Air Max 1s are a pretty comfortable shoe. Not the most comfortable, it's still a pretty old shoe with pretty ancient technology, but overall, it is comfortable. Over time, I've come to actually feel like it's more comfortable. It's a light shoe, it's pretty well cushioned, you don't feel super flat to the ground. I think it strikes a really good balance. Padding inside, around the ankle collar, all very sufficient. I could definitely wear an Air Max 1 like every single day. And that brings the total sole score of the Air Max 1 Beef and Broccoli to 27 out of 40. Pretty average score compared to other general releases. Now, in terms of colorway, do appreciate the theme of the shoe, but I don't love the colorway. Like I said at the beginning of the video, this shade of green with the brown, I think it's just slightly out of my comfort zone. I don't love the combination on a sneaker. I do really like the shades of brown though. I think that works really well, but together, yeah, it's just not my favorite. Now, in terms of the materials, if you're into hairy suede or hairier suede than smooth feeling suede, you'll definitely like this shoe. For me, I do like smoother, more plush feeling suede than this one. And I do prefer a leather base Air Max 1s. I know Air Max 1s typically don't come with a leather base. Just in a vacuum, I do prefer leather over everything. So in terms of materials, I think it's kind of personal preference. If you're into that hairy suede, I think you'll like it. Now in terms of comfort, I think Air Max 1s are a pretty comfortable shoe. Not the most comfortable, but it's good. I could definitely wear it all day, no problems. The cushioning is decent. You don't feel super flat to the ground. It's not the stiff feeling shoe. The cushioning and padding inside, really decent. Now, in terms of the versatility of the shoe, the Air Max 1, just in terms of the silhouette itself, very, very, very versatile. I know it kind of looks more like a running shoe. Obviously, that was what it was intended for, but casual use, it works really well. Maybe apart from formal occasions, I wouldn't wear an Air Max 1, but every other occasion, I would. Now, in terms of the versatility of the colorway, this is where it becomes a bit tougher. If you're into this more rugged look, and if this is what you're used to, I think you might find it very easy to wear, but trying to be objective, looking at it in a vacuum, I think the brown and green colorway, it is just harder to wear than a brown and white, or a red and white, blue and white, obviously, black and white. Doesn't capture a super wide audience, but if you're into this look, you'll like the versatility of the shoe. Now the Beef and Broccoli colorway, it might not be my favorite in terms of just looking at it through the lens of a sneaker lover. The brown and green, it's not two colors that I love on sneakers, but I do appreciate the kind of tie-in to Beef and Broccoli. As an Asian person, I obviously appreciate an Eastern influence on sneakers, and that's why I wanted to review it. It's not my favorite colorway, but I do like the inspiration. So that's it. Thanks for watching, Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Nike Air Max 1 Beef and Broccoli. Subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.